In the last video, we took a look at the general tab, which is this one here. And in this one, we're going to take a look at profiles. So I'm just going to give myself a little bit of room here. All right. Over here on the left, you'll notice that we are currently in the basic profile, and it matches this one here on my left. You have about 10 or so profiles that you can choose from. I can just go through them here. And at the bottom, I kind of made my own little custom profile, which I'm going to kind of show you how to do. So if you want to see a quick preview of the profiles and what they look like, you can just go to the actual image icon and you can double click that and it will pop up, and it will pop up with the default window size and the shell and your home directory. And let's look at one more. Okay, so I'm not going to go through all of them, but you can just go through them and check them out and see which one you'd like, you know, maybe to start off or just keep a default. And I'm going to show you right now how to create one based on using one of these default templates. So let's just pick one. We'll start with, say, Red Son. So once you've selected the template or the default profile over here, you can just go down to this circle with an ellipsis here, and you can hit the drop down menu and you can duplicate the profile and you can name it whatever you want. So this one I'm just going to call Williams. And when you're done, you just commit by hitting enter, and it will make an exact replica of Red Sans. Okay, so we're just going to open up our duplicate, the one that we duplicated, and we're going to take a look at some of the settings over here. We have a bunch of various tabs over here. We have text, window, tabs, shell, keyboard, and advanced. So we're going to start with the text area tab, and we're going to go through what you can do to the duplicated template that you have and you renamed, and we're going to see how we can modify this. So in this section, you have a little sub area here called backgrounds, and you have a little thing here called color and effects. You can click the color well, or click on this tab here, it'll bring up the color well, and you can modify the color of the background. So we can just use these sliders, we can change things like the opacity, and we can change the color. So depending on what we want, we can change, you know, whether we want a light or darker contrast of that color, or you can change the color altogether by just selecting whatever color you feel in the color well. If you don't like the color well option, you can go through here and pick a slider, or you can choose, you know, Apple's color deck. You can reference it from an image, like a spectrum, if you wanted to do that. Or you can use this kind of color well. I really just don't really have a preference. I just stick with the default, and I'll go through here and I'll modify that. At the bottom here, you can sample colors using the ink dropper, and you can save colors that you like or found interesting. I'm just going to bring this back up to 100 for now. I'm going to show you that you can just sample a color by clicking here. You can go anywhere on your page, or if you had an image open or something, and you can click on that, and the ink dropper will sample the color. And if you wanted to use that color, you just drag and drop it, and you can save it anywhere in this area where you can keep a palette of the colors that you like. Let's see how this applies to changing this. Just before we do that, there's one more thing in the background area, which is you can change the image background. So if you had an image that you wanted to select, you can change the background image of the, you know, the default one you're going to duplicate here that you have duplicated. I just leave that alone because really it's up to you. It's all a big style preference and your choice. But for the most part, I don't want an image in the area back here. Let's go to see what we can do to modify this. So I've changed this here and lowered the opacity. I'm going to close this. I'm going to reopen it. And let's see. It's hard to see, it's very subtle. I hope you can see it, but the opacity has dropped to be about 50%. So it means that this window is now translucent. You can see through it. You didn't really notice it over here because it's on a black background, but as I drop the opacity, the window becomes more and more translucent. And the color, let's see if we can change this. All right, so if you cycle through the actual color well here, you can see that I am modifying the color background, and I can also adjust the transparency here. And there's a thing called blur, which is kind of interesting. So over here, if we look at the contents below the window, you can see that it's slightly blurred out or it's not fully transparent. And this you can do by adjusting the blurring settings here. So you can completely blur it or make it fully, I guess, opaque, or so that you can't see through it. Or you can make it, you know, a little bit, bring the blur radius down to like 6% or something. But I find that might be a little distracting, because if you look at this, you know, as you're typing something in terminal, you can clearly see, you know, what's beneath it. So for now, I like to keep that around, you know, give or take 36%, depending. So I like to know there's something behind it, but I don't want to see the details of what's actually behind this window. I'm just picking some arbitrary colors, so just you can pick whatever color you feel, and we'll just move ahead with the next section, okay? So once you have your color, and you have changed this background color and effect, and if you wanted to do so, you could add an image. The next thing up is the font area. This is where you can change the font to whatever font or typeface you want to use. I'm just going to change the size of the font for right now. For now, I'd like it around 14, and that's all you need. And then you just close this. So below here in this area, we also have the text that you can modify. I just kind of leave them as is for now. And if you don't know what the ANSI color is, it basically just displays text using the colors embedded in some terminal emulator. So there's some standards, and it just says, okay, yeah, I want those standards in place, and I want the terminal to emulate those standards. Over here, we have use bright colors for bold text. Like, I kind of leave this alone, because when you change this anyway and you enable bold text, it's pretty bright depending on the color, but you can turn that on if you need to. So right now our text is this maybe skin color or like light gold. If you double click it, it brings up the color well, and you can cycle through the color well once again to kind of pick the color that you want. This light blue, I can change the opacity by adjusting the slider. I'm going to keep it to 100% for now, and then I'm going to close the color well. So we change that color, and then you could work on the bold color. So let's just type in a command real quick. We'll type in ls, and we're going to hit the X button over here to close the color well. Make sure we select the terminal that you're editing, or the default shell that you're, you know, just manipulating right now. And you notice that like the highlighted area turned to this color, this like maroon. So that's the selection. So if we were to click that and you wanted a different selection color, something maybe a little less intrusive, you select the actual terminal, you go to the color well, and you start to move this around to find a color that is maybe not no, that's appropriate for what you're trying to do. So like if I was to highlight all of this with this ANSI blue text, I mean, that might be hard on the eyes, but you can adjust the selection to something that maybe you might find a little bit more appropriate to view the text that you're currently looking at. So this is not bad. So when you're done that, you can select that and just hit X to close. All right, we will clear this. Okay, and the next part is the ANSI color, ANSI color, depending on what you want to do here. I just leave these as default. I'll get into like color schemes that you can like download, or there's areas that you can find like you know, color schemes that make terminal default settings, whatever ones you modify or ones you want to import, look a lot better. I'll just leave this alone for now. And in one of our previous videos, we took a look at the cursor. So I think by default, it was like a block cursor, and we were able to change it to underline in this case. I like mine vertical, so I like just the vertical bar, and I like the cursor blinking. So make sure if you want to see those effects, you select the terminal that you're working on, like the thing that you're modifying, you check these off. And you can also open the color well once again to choose a color that is like appropriate for whatever theme or, you know, color style that you're going for. So you close that and we jump back in. And as you can see, the color cursor has been modified to the color that you chose. In this case, I went vertical. It's blinking, and here it is. Do remember that we have all these things applied to it. There is a translucency or an opacity change. There is a blur. I just have the original terminal basic open over here, so you really can't see those effects. But I'm just moving it around for you to give you an idea of what the changes are like. So once you have that done, if you go back to General, we can now select that we would like Williams, or whatever you name your modified or duplicated default terminal profile. You can select it here, and so when terminal starts up again, we will start with this. So let's just see if that works out. So we will close the template we are modifying. We will quit terminal. We will use Spotlight to open terminal once again. And as you can see, it looks completely different because of this colorful background. My green doesn't look as green. The terminal is transparent to a degree. It has a blur. And we will bring back up preferences, and we will continue with profile things. So we'll head back over to profile. And you might have noticed that the window size has changed. It's no longer what we originally set, because on my custom default profile, I had made some modifications for the window size that I showed you guys in a previous video. So on this one, we're going to do relatively the same thing. So to do so, we're going to go into the next tab, which is window, and we will control the window size and columns here.